Moving forward to our next topic, fundraising. Fundraising is an extreme sport and is a necessary evil in many cases and scenarios. In broad spectrum, funding is a term that is implemented when a company needs money from its internal assets and capital. May I now call Dr. Arun Singhvi on stage to please discuss fundraising, scaling up, and entrepreneurship in ophthalmology. What vital factors should entrepreneurs be alert to in order to raise the maximum amount of funding and be able to enjoy the journey to the top?
Hello. I extend a warm welcome to the blue city of Jodhpur to you all. I belong to this place and probably I don't go to conferences very much, but couldn't skip this as it was in my city. So, thank you, Senthil, for giving the opportunity. And the topic given is probably given because ASG has done this, so Senthil would have felt, let's hear from it, that how is what done. But this is all given in Google and data and YouTube, and we have seen that also. So everything is given everywhere. They'll tell you what to do, they'll tell you how to do, they'll tell you when to do, but nobody will tell you why to do. It's only when somebody feels he has to do it, will do it actually. This why is very important. Everything revolves around this why. So if your why is very strong and you can live with it, excited throughout your life for whatever you are doing, then probably go and do it. Because every why will be unique. Every need, every hunger, every path, every story will be unique. So this why will be unique for every company, for every individual. And the problem is that we always discuss how and what and when. So first I would suggest everybody, including people in our organization, we discuss this. Why we have done this? Why should we do it? Because there are few people who have founded company would know how taxing it is, how demanding it is, how much of an emotional cost and consequences are attached to it. So it's only this passion and dedicated hard work for a prolonged period will actually make you sail through it. If you have a strong why, and if you are excited about it, and you can be excited, because happinesses will come, but will come with more sadnesses on the way of this creating something. So the excitement, I say, is beyond happiness and sadness, which actually makes you passionate to do it. So probably, when I say every story is unique, then you'll say, what was your why? And our why came from our families. The why can be anything. Why can be a very simple thing. And I would not at all pretend to, for even a moment, I would not pretend that we knew everything 10 to 15 years back. It was very difficult to bring children up. We had to drop our coachings. We all wanted to go to IITs, but we couldn't go to Kota, blah, blah, blah. So that was the story. And so our why was very simple. We wanted to be in India, and we never wanted to do a government job. This was our why we started ASG. So this why is not small. Everything else will happen. But when you have burnt your ships that you'll not be able to do a government job, you have to do a private practice. You join somewhere, you start your own. But then that was clear that we will start our own practice. And to fund that, Shashank went to UAE for some job. Our wives are also working. and I started in 2005. Probably me and Shashank have been together for past almost 26 years, I would say, precisely 26 years. And the business happened 14 years back. So the togetherness came before business. We still live in one house. Both families, both parents, one kitchen, one house. That's till date. So there is a point why I'm stressing on this. Because this is the culture we have tried to spread at ASG. This is the togetherness. We'll do anything to keep people together. We'll try everything to keep people together. This togetherness came before business, and path becomes easy if people are together. So with this thought, it's not adjusting with each other. Togetherness doesn't mean adjusting with each other. So for me, I would say the most precious feeling in my life would be to be accepted for what I am. That's togetherness. Accept a person for what he is. With this, we started in 2005, first center at Jodhpur. Come 2007, we started a peripheral OPD setup at the other end of the city. 2008, we did a cataract center at 60 kilometers from this place. 2009, we started a setup, a semi-hub, you can say, minus LASIK, a center at Bikaner, which is 250 kilometers from this place. 2010, we did again a small cataract center midway between Jodhpur and Bikaner. That's a place called Nagaur. 2011, we did a center at Jaipur. That center was a big hub, a full-fledged hub. We invested whatever we had earned. There was no saving. There was nothing we saved. So probably, knowingly or unknowingly, we had created a model where, rather two models I would say, where one was we had done two hubs, Jodhpur, Jaipur, one semi-hub and three spokes. And parallelly, a model of culture or a model of togetherness, which I always say, was going on parallelly, where we were able to convince young ophthalmologists from our institute as well as other people who joined us, were able to convince the importance and the benefits which can come with teamwork. We at that moment never approached any senior person, or we never tried to amalgamate seniors, because we felt they've already achieved in their life and it would be difficult for them to adjust to this environment. So with this two parallel models developing, and I'm talking of 2012 was the probably one of the best years for ophthalmology. Ophthalmology was leading the single specialty platform. 3-4 chains had already been funded, and probably one of the unicorns of ophthalmology had taken everybody by such a stride that they had made such a remarkable, irreversible change as to how to do private practices. So the time was very opportune. It was, I would say, the golden era of ophthalmology at that time. That's when we went, we thought, let's try and replicate this model which we have tried to do here elsewhere. Though we partly knew that there are flaws in the model, we are not being successful the way we wanted to be, but then still we went for a fundraise. It can be debated, it was right, wrong, we were of a critical size or not, we were ready for it or not, but whatever happened, happened, whatever happens is for good. So we went for a fundraise in 2012, and after all the processes, In 2013, we had our money in the bank and first investor coming in. So something about investors, I was talking to, so I have, and you can understand by seeing me, I have not prepared the talk. I'm just trying to recollect and tell it to you the way it has happened. I was talking to Santhil day before and I said, so what do I have to say? He said, say whatever you feel like, what have you done? Something about investors, something about the journey. So something about investors. The popular belief is, and yesterday also in the evening we would have heard amongst ourselves, investors will push you, investors will poke you, investors will take away your freedom, investors will make you do which you don't want to do. It's not right. Probably why I've written this is, if you are not convinced, they'll confuse you. That's for sure. They're very smart people, extremely smart, smarter than we would have ever thought. But then they have invested in you. Their money is with you. They want to see your progress. They want to actually help you out with everything to grow. That's the attitude I think about the investor. But the point is, we ourselves were not very, very convinced with the model we were drawing. We were seeing some flaws in the spokes. We were feeling, our spokes are not working. Hubs are doing relatively okay. Energy is being divided so much that spokes also take the same amount of energy, rather more. For a cataract center, you cannot have two doctors. One doctor takes leave. He's not a good surgeon. He doesn't want to stay in small place. So it was getting very difficult. But then they came with a preset mind. And probably during fundraise, we were also not very clear about what we wanted to do with that money. So our fragile minds also got confused with whatever other chains or the unicorns were doing. We also went ahead with the rapid expansion phase. So as I've told you, we were doing one center per year, probably one center per year. And suddenly with the money coming in, we invested the whole lot and we opened 15 centers in 15 months. So that's a real fact. 15 centers in 15 months, no bench strength. But the energy was so high, the bullishness was so high. Today you can call it a foolishness, but it was so high in energy that we thought we'll do it. And we did it. Khol diye 15 center. And suddenly, because we were also not from any financial background, neither our parents, neither our families, nobody. And suddenly you come to know you have ended with everything. And you just have 2-3 months of salaries left in your account and your all centers are bleeding. But still we felt it's okay. We have investors. We'll go to them. We'll talk to them. It's okay. We just went to them. We went to banks also for debt raise, which we knew we won't be able to do it with the kind of balance sheets we had. But then investors were also there. So we went to them. Initially the calls were unanswered. Then they said we'll talk to our bosses in US. And finally after a month, month and a half, they came up with the answer that the ASG investment had got busted. You have to find your own way. We cannot help you anymore. So that's where you get the shock of life. Because they can help you. They can help you grow. They can suggest you. But you have to be convinced yourself of what to do. They'll not run it for you. They cannot run it. Had they been able to run it, they would have run it themselves. They wouldn't have invested in us. So that's the time when the theme before it, the togetherness, comes into play. When you have spread the culture of togetherness in ASG, people became ready. Few of us grouped together, 5-6 of us. They said, we'll help you out. We all got together, 100 of us out of 500. I think it was around 500 strength we had of doctors and colleagues. So 100 of us took salary cuts. We just took bare minimum amount to run our families for 6 months or so. That's where we started analyzing. We thought we had been written off. There was nothing which we could do. We had to bounce back. We had to analyze fast. We were running out of time. We then started thinking about gross margins, then started thinking about back integration of pharma, of optical, about hiring right kind of doctors, about how do we launch centers, what kind of a model we drive in. We distributed work amongst ourselves. We five of us, somebody took HR, somebody said, I want to do marketing optical, somebody said, operations mein dekh lunga. I was given the task for strategy, future expansion, and projects. That was me, along with the so-called investors and the back integration process and gross margins. So then came the tough time. And when the tough time comes, you have to take hard calls. So I probably was not liked in the organization for a year, year and a half when I started shutting down the centers. I said goodbye to a few doctors. We shut down 8 of them. Out of 15 we had opened, 8 were gone. The thing which I felt at that time was, before this debacle happened, probably I was doing everything. And Himanshu is there, he'll be speaking on something else later and he can vouch for it. I was doing everything. I was doing clinicals. I was doing projects, investors, doctors hiring, pharma, consumables, everything. And was not able to justify anything. So when we divided the work and I took partly, and I have taken strong backseat, but at that time I took partly backseat on clinicals. I said, you all take care of that. I'll probably go and arrange some money from private lenders. We did that, and that's okay. Everybody will get some support from somewhere. But the interest we paid for good 2 years was 18%. So that's where some private lenders helped us. What I'm trying to say, what I learned at that time was, we probably have to communicate it to the whole team, and the whole team has to be excited about whatever we want to do in future now. We took a call, we will not open more than 2 centers for next 2 years. We will improvise, standardize, partly templatize, and make it success from start. And that's where I call change of face of ASG started in 2015. 2 years we opened 4 centers, 2 each. That's what we had thought of. Stabilized things. It became, yeah, we are okay now, we don't need anybody help. But then we came to know this is really what we wanted to do. Because this time there was no pressure and team was united and dreaming, we could actually do what we had thought of. Now we start feeling, I mean, we have learnt now, we want to grow now. This is the time we need money. Whatever money initially we had got had gone in learning. But then 2017, I said 2 years we did 2 centers. So 2017, the time was extremely rough. The unicorn had fallen. IPOs didn't come. Companies were not able to do fundings. Bad time for ophthalmology. Ophthalmology now was considered as okay. If somebody is an outlier, only then we'll invest. Otherwise, no good times for us. So that time we thought, okay, we'll be hit on valuations, but time is opportune. Nobody is expanding. Let's try and do a fundraise. So we took a hit on our valuation, went ahead for fundraise with a very clear thought and very clear mindset what we wanted to do with this fund. We did a fundraise in 2017. This was our second round. And for the last 2 years, I would say, we have fairly done what we had taken that money for. We have experimented, we have implemented. Whole the team what wanted, we have implemented. We, by the way, we love technology. We are a company who loves technology, but only if it adds significant clinical value to our skill sets. We will not do anything to earn a lot out of it, even if it doesn't help you beyond a point. If it doesn't, we care for patients' value for money. We all love growth. We all are very passionate about creating value for organization as well as for self. For past 2 years, we did what we wanted to. Finally, we have recently, 3-4 months back, we have given exit to our first investor. They have made good returns, almost a 4-4.5x of their invested amount. Happy for them. But frankly, we don't work for any investor now. We work for organization, we work for our people. It's a doctor-based organization. We do not have management people. We ourselves do management, all doctors team together. We definitely take help from our homegrown management team. But they are people who have been with us for 10, 12 years now. So it's an organization where we like to partner with people. We like to partner with people who are passionate for growth, may it be young or old. But it shouldn't be for just trading practices. Inorganic or brownfield doesn't mean trading practices. That's what we have seen happening. It's about future. It's something about, every company falls in the trap of let's relish the triumph of a comeback. But I always tell my team, be worried about future. If you're not worried about tomorrow, you'll never be able to reap the betterments and benefits and excitement which comes with tomorrow. Ours is an organization where I would say we want people to come, to practice, to learn, to manage, to run the show for a good period of time, and then take a back seat and hand it over to the next generation and do whatever else they want to do in life. And along with it, create value, create repute, create wealth for self and family. That's probably it. I mean, that's what ASG has been doing, and this journey will continue. Thank you.